Well, I've got a question on my mind, Chris. I wasn't around, I don't know if you did this the wrong way, but I wasn't around when Elvis really conquered the world. What do you remember?
Well, you missed something. I don't know, on the television back in those days, it was something that everybody was watching. It was like, it would only show you half of it, so the rest of it was up to your imagination, and everybody was going crazy about it. The thing I remember was that Elvis seemed to be in on the joke. He never took himself seriously.
That's amazing. Well, let's see what it all looked like back in 1956, when Heartbreak Hotel was the hottest record in the nation.
For 6 weeks, Elvis was a regular on the Dorsey Brothers show. But it was when he did Hound Dog on Milton Berle that the whole country went crazy.
Friendly criticized, even by usually mild and gentle TV critics. Now, do you bear any animosity towards these critics?
Well, not really. Most people have a job to do, and they do it.
And do you think you've learned anything from the criticism level?
No, I haven't.
You haven't?
Because I don't feel that I'm doing anything wrong.
On September 9, 1956, over 50 million people, a record 83% of those watching TV, turned on the Ed Sullivan Show to see what all the ruckus was about. Even if on his final Sullivan appearance he agreed to be filmed only from the waist up, it didn't matter. Elvis had become the king.
Performing Heartbreak Hotel, the song that started the romance between Elvis and the two, please welcome John Cale.
Este meu ao vivo em Paris, com a sua namorada, ou o quê? Uma rosa vermelha a pousar em cima do piano, ou o quê? Mas foi assim um bocado chato, porque eu estava a contar que ele ia sozinho, e ele veio sozinho, e o piano e o violão e a minha, a dar-lhe uma mão, ou o quê?
I found a new place to dwell. Down. Heartbreak Hotel feels so lonely. Feels so lonely. Feels so lonely.
Just fine.